everyone, it's Ali here from topgurus.com. How you doing today? It's amazing to be here now. I am super excited. We have this amazing tool. We've come to this part where I want to show you this tool on how you can build WordPress websites on your computer. You don't need internet. And the most important and sexy part is that it's free, okay? So this is a way that we can create websites for ourselves, for our clients, but creating it in our own environment, on our computer, without internet access if we don't need it, and being able to then take a super easy, taking the website from your computer, uploading it to your hosting, and showing your clients. And with this great bit of this great tool here, what you can also do is be able to show your clients through live links on how the website's progressing. In the old days, that would have been something very complicated. You would have been building your website on your computer. Your client would be saying, "How's my website coming along?" And you'd be like, "Yeah, yeah, it's doing well, it's doing well." And they want to see it. And that would have been super complicated to actually show them the website you've been creating on the computer. But nowadays, this is super easy using this great tool. Let's show you how to use it. So what you want to do is you want to come to your browser and you want to go to localwp.com. This will bring up the page. This is local by Flywheel. It's Flywheel is actually its own hosting company. It's a bit like WP Engine. It's a great hosting company. They created this tool that you'll be able to easily upload WordPress websites to their hosting. But with this tool, you can actually build websites for any hosting. You don't actually have to use Flywheel for the actual server for the hosting. You can come in here and use it for any types of hosting using certain plugins and stuff. So I'm just going to come over here, click download. You can use it Mac, Windows, Linux, whatever you want to use it on. That's the great thing. And as did I mention, it's free. So you can just click on Mac, choose a name, choose a last name, choose an email, and then you click get it now. What it's going to do, it's going to download it to my computer. It's about 240, 250 megs. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to cancel that because I already have it downloaded. I don't want to waste your valuable time by having to download it. Here it is here. This process, you know, you just download like you would normal with any other software. Just download, install it onto your computer. On Mac, it's super easy. I'm just going to double click on it. I'm going to drag it to the applications folder. It's then going to install it in my applications folder. I'm then going to close this down. I'm going to close this down. And there it is there. Click on local. And here we go, getting excited on with this new tool. So it's going to ask you, do you want to open it up? Yep, I want to open it, allow permissions for that. I'm going to close this down so we can focus solely on the actual tool here. It's going to ask you if you want to agree. Of course, you have to agree, otherwise you cannot proceed. This is a good thing. It's going to ask you if you want error reporting. Error reporting comes in handy should there be errors during your, you know, when building your websites. I always like to turn it on, there's no harm. I'm just gonna close this X down. And here we are. Doesn't it look super simple? Like some of these other tools that you use, and I've used a lot of them, they're like complicated. You have to turn on Apache servers, like it gets super, super complicated. So this is the look as you first come in. You can create a new site down here. You can also do one from the bottom. This is the information. You can upgrade to Pro. Pro has some extra value to it. It allows you to do like custom link Pro stuff. It costs 20 bucks a month if you're gonna be creating this, like let's say you become a developer and this really what you're gonna be doing. Having the Pro version might come in handy, but for where we're at, you can just get along with the free version just fine. These are different connections. These are add-ons that you can add. And then it's the help with the local community. So what we want to do is we want to create our new site and we want to give this site a name. I'm going to give this site Tats. We'll just call it that, just being super original here. And what you'll notice is when I click on the advanced options, this is the URL. So this will be the URL of the website, meaning you go to tats.local and then it will open up the website. We'll show you that in a sec. So whatever you put in here gets put in here. I'm just going to keep that as Tats. This is the local site path, so this is where all the files and stuff are saved to your computer. If you want to change that, you can choose browse. Do you use a blueprint? At the moment, we're not. Blueprint allows you to create certain features inside of WordPress and then save them. So save them as a theme, save all of a pre-built sort of looking type of site that you can use over and over again. Really powerful, but we will get into that a lot later. I'm going to click continue. It says, oh, so what I've already had this on my computer for this tutorial. I took it off and added a new one. So we basically, if you get that error, it means that you already have a pre-existing folder. Call that. So I'm just going to call it. I'm just going to call it tutorials. Okay, and then I'm going to click continue. Should work now. And when you get to the next page, what's going to happen is it's going to give you a preferred option or a custom. Custom option allows you to choose what PHP version you want to use, what type of web server, what type of database you want to use. That all sounds super scary if you're new to this. I like to choose the preferred. It gives me the latest PHP version, the MySQL database, gives me all the stuff that I need, and I'm going to click continue. You then need to assign a username and password. This will be to log into the back end of it. I'm just gonna, what shall I do? I'm gonna make it complex, admin123. I'm then gonna stick in an email. An email's good should you forget what your username and password is or something like that. It's always good to set up a WordPress email address. It can be any email. Advanced options, is this a WordPress multiple site? I'm just gonna choose no for now. We're gonna come in later on and show you how to add multiple sites. So basically you use one WordPress and you can run multiple sites on that. But for now, we're gonna click no. We will do it in a later tutorial. We will talk about that more, but let's just keep this simple for now. Add site. And what this is gonna do, it's gonna do its flywheel magic, and it's gonna create a WordPress website on your actual computer. It might actually ask you to allow permissions. So I'm just gonna do that. Close that down. So yeah, it'll now it's just downloading the WordPress. It's going to be installing it on your computer and your local server. It's going to it's going to allow us to log in from your computer. This works, like I said before, internet, no internet, you can still log in. That's the power of it. Like for someone like me who travels a lot, having something like this where I can still work on clients' websites and be in an environment where there isn't necessarily internet. I live in Thailand. In some places, internet's not always the best speed, shall we say. So it's nearly done. It's just downloading WordPress as we speak. It's now installed. It's you'll see here the overview. So it's given the type of web server, the PHP version, the database, MySQL, latest version of WordPress, site domain. I'm gonna keep this as a local. You can actually have this set up to be a .com or something like that. For now, because we're doing in this particular course here, we're understanding WordPress. We'll do more of that later. SSL, is it multiple sites? Does it have more than one site? And it's no. You then have your database information here. This is where it's located. This is username and password. This is the database name. Utilities and tools, which you can actually, as I said before, you can have a pro version where it allows you to use more tools. If you want to find out where all the files are located on your computer, you just click that little arrow there and you'll notice here they are, all these different types on your computer. Another thing that I want to point out is that, let's say for example, you turn your computer off, you go home, you turn your computer off, you've done days of work, and when you come back tomorrow, you come back into your website and you refresh and the website's not appearing. Well, when you come back into Flywheel, you need to come up the top here and make sure you have up the top here, start site. For example, I'm just going to stop the site and I'm going to refresh, and you're going to notice that the website brings up an internal error. You see here, request error. This is because that the flywheel is actually turned off. So when you come back to Flywheel, click on the actual website that you want to work on, come up to start site. And once you start site, once everything looks like it's finished here, when you refresh, WordPress website will be back. So this is something that can drive people mental if you don't know how to work with it. So what we have here on the right is we have admin, which will log us into the admin, and we have open site. So let's just have a quick look and see what it looks like. So this is the installed theme. This is the WordPress. This is what it looks like, okay? Real basic, ugly, not much happening, but we're gonna change that soon. Then what you've got, if I quickly come back to click on admin, so I come back to the server here, click admin, I use the username and password that I created. Make sure I've got that correct, yep. And I'm gonna log in. When you log in, you'll now notice that we have a fresh install of WordPress, which we're going to come through bit by bit, explaining on what it all means. But as you can see, you've easily, in a few clicks of buttons, come in, added a WordPress website onto your computer, and you are ready to create some magic. So that's it for this tutorial. If you like these videos, we've got lots more videos. Please subscribe, click the like button, and if you're looking for notifications when we upload new videos, because we're going to be very active on this YouTube channel, just click that little bell, bing, and that will notify you anytime we're adding up new tutorials. Thanks everyone, guys and girls. Great to see you all, and we look forward to seeing you in the next tutorial.